Welcome back to Online Video Student. This time we're taking a look at another new feature in iOS 11, Control Center. A lot of the changes in iOS 11 appear to be just cosmetic, but underneath there's been a lot of work done and a lot of increases to productivity and usability. One of those areas is Control Center. To enter Control Center, simply sweep up from the bottom of any screen. The first thing you're going to notice is that almost everything has changed. Looking around Control Center, you'll notice that everything is basically divided into two sections. The top portion contains your basic controls. Here's where you're going to have access to your connectivity connections like wireless, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi. And you'll also have access to your music, brightness, volume, do not disturb, rotation lock, and screen mirroring options. Below this is going to be where you're going to be able to customize and add options to Control Center. With the new Control Center, 3D Touch becomes even more useful. Holding down on items pops it open and gives you more options for that setting. A very important thing to notice about Control Center when you're talking about the connectivity elements is that it doesn't do exactly what you think it does. When you turn off the Wi-Fi or you turn off the Bluetooth, you're simply disconnecting from the currently connected device or network. To actually physically turn off the antenna, you need to either go into airplane mode or you need to go into the settings and physically turn off the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi to deactivate the antenna. In addition to controlling airplane mode, turning cellular data on or off, disconnecting or reconnecting with Bluetooth, you can also control AirDrop settings in this pane, and you can turn on or off the personal hotspot directly from here as well. The real power of the new Control Center is seen in the lower section of the screen where you're able to customize what's showing up there. By default, you've got the flashlight, stopwatch, calculator, and camera. But going into Settings, under Control Center, you can customize the controls. In a screen, you can see what's already included in your Control Center at the top, and with the red button on the left-hand side, you can delete out anything that you don't want anymore. But as you scroll down, you'll see the different controls that are available for you to add. Everything from alarm, Apple TV remote, do not disturb while driving, low power mode directly from the Control Center, notes, stopwatch, and wallet. You can add any of these directly into your Control Center and then be able to access them from there, including screen recording. So let's add a few things. And then when we go back into Control Center, now we can see the items that we've added. Screen recording, Apple TV, and alarm clock are all down here at the bottom. Accessing these are just as easy as tapping on any of the buttons. Now, once you've added items to the Control Center, you can customize it even further by rearranging the buttons at the bottom. Simply go back to Control Center Controls and the Settings and customize the controls. You'll notice on the right-hand side there are three lines. Simply grab and hold down any of these to rearrange the buttons wherever you'd like them to appear. When you go back into Control Center, you see that the changes have been made. If you don't like it where it is, you can move it back. But with this, you're able to customize not only what shows up in Control Center, but how it appears and in what order. And that's a quick rundown of iOS 11's new Control Center. We hope you've enjoyed this video, and please give it a thumbs up if you did. And of course, please subscribe to our channel. We'd love to hear from you in a comment, and we'd especially like to hear from you with suggestions about videos and topics we can cover in the future. Thanks again, and we'll see you soon.